Hello everyone, I'm Orestes from Celestial Textures, and in this video we'll show you how to use the MIDI Auto LFO of Cubase to modulate some native channel parameters, and also you can use this technique so you can modulate anything you prefer with a MIDI controller or any other MIDI modulation device. Other DAWs like Ableton and Bitwig, they have this feature in a more user-friendly environment, but also in Cubase is possible with the following process. For PC users, I will suggest you to download and install the Loop-E1 MIDI driver from the nerds.dev website. This is a free internal MIDI driver that you can use to send MIDI parameters internally from one MIDI device to another. For Mac users, you don't need that, as Mac OS X provides IAC driver that you can find it under the Finder menu, select Go, Utilities, and select again Audio MIDI Setup. On the Window menu, select Show MIDI Studio. If you don't see any IAC driver, you can add it. Just be sure that the driver is enabled. As I will proceed with this video on Windows, for the Mac users, the only thing that you will need to have in mind is that every time that I'm using Loop-E1 driver, you will need to use the IAC Mac driver. I will add a new audio track and I will import one audio file for our example. Now we need to go to the Studio menu, Studio Setup, and add a generic remote device. This will be the device we are going to use to modulate the native Cubase parameters. In the MIDI in and output of our device, we will set up Loop-E1 internal MIDI driver. Our MIDI channel will be channel 1. The generic remote device is loaded with some default settings, and we will need to go and change all the MIDI channels that are assigned to the MIDI channel 1. Like that, we will be safe that our LFO will not change any other parameters we don't really like. On the address, we will set our MIDI controller ID. We can use values from 0 to 127. For this example, I will start from the MIDI controller ID 20. On the bottom list, you will have to select on the channel category the destination that you want to modulate. For example, can be a specific audio MIDI track, the one we have selected, or even a device. On the value action parameter, we need to set which element of the device we have selected we want to modulate. For example, panorama, volume control, or EQ frequency. Now I will create a MIDI channel and I will set the MIDI input to none and the MIDI output to our Loop-E1 MIDI driver. Be sure that our MIDI channel is the same with the one we have configured in the generic device. We will go to the MIDI inserts and insert the Auto LFO. We will need to set the control type of the Auto LFO to the first MIDI address ID that we have configured in the studio setup of our generic remote device. As you can see, our channel is being modulated by our Auto LFO, and I will add one more for our second modulation. I will add one more for our third modulation. I hope you enjoy the video. This is a way to modulate any native parameter of Cubase with AutoLFO or with any other MIDI device or modulator. Thank you for watching and see you next time.